This Is All She Needs, a Jade Savage FBI suspense thriller, Book 4, written by Molly Black, read by Caroline. Prologue. Ryan Hartwell was right where he belonged. The yacht swayed gently on the Pacific, its grandeur a beacon amidst the ink-black waters. A constellation of lights cascaded from its decks, illuminating faces lifted in laughter and lips curved around crystal flutes. The night air was thick with the scent of saline and opulence, carrying the melodies of a string quartet that danced over the waves. Ryan's eyes roved across the sea of attendees, celebrities with their camera-ready grins, tycoons with power resting easily on their shoulders, and socialites draped in the shimmering larceny of diamonds. They were all here for the charity he championed, their pockets as open as their admiration for him. And he loved every second of it. Every second their attention was on him. He was glowing. "Thank you all for joining us tonight," Ryan began, projecting his voice as far as he could. Heads nodded, applause ebbed and flowed, and Ryan felt the familiar surge of accomplishment. Here he was, the master conductor of success, orchestrating an evening where fortunes would align for the greater good. But as he wove into the heart of his speech, an odd sensation pricked at his composure. His forehead, usually cool under pressure, betrayed him with a sheen of sweat. He dabbed at it discreetly with a handkerchief, attributing the anomaly to the balmy night air. Yet, when he resumed speaking, his words snagged like a frayed thread. "The efforts we, put forth tonight." Ryan felt ill. This wasn't like him. He loved speaking to crowds. Was it stage fright? No. Bad food? Maybe. The room's attentive silence became a palpable entity, pressing against his temples. Dizziness crept upon him, a spectral hand tilting his world on an axis. He wrestled for control, casting a glance towards the crowd. They were a blur of expectancy, waiting for him to reclaim his narrative. "Excuse me," he stuttered, the words sticking like burrs in his throat. "I must have lost my place." Light laughter rippled through the audience, a lifeline thrown with good-natured humour. Ryan clung to it, attempting to smile, yet his vision tunnelled, narrowing to pinpricks of light. He tried to ground himself, fixating on a single face in the crowd, willing his equilibrium to return, but the features of the guests melded into a carousel of colours, spinning ever faster. Within his chest, his heartbeat thrummed erratically, a drumbeat out of sync with the calm he desperately sought to portray. "Please," he said, his voice barely above a whisper now. The command of it lost somewhere between his faltering heartbeats and the lapping of the ocean against the yacht's hull. The floor beneath him seemed to undulate, a treacherous tide rising to claim his poise and leaving him adrift in uncertainty. He knew he had to get out of there and compose himself before he made the front page news as a total joke. "Sorry, one second, folks." Ryan ignored their chatter as his shoes clicked urgently against the teak flooring as he made his way through a gilded archway, away from the sea of faces and the suddenly unbearable weight of their attention. The corridor was dim in comparison to the ballroom's radiance, lined with gleaming brass sconces that cast elongated shadows on the walls. He welcomed the solitude, the lack of eyes upon him, but it did little to steady the world that seemed to tilt and sway with each laboured step. "Fresh air," he muttered to himself, a mantra to keep moving forward. His hand trailed along the wall for support, fingertips grazing the textured wallpaper until they reached the cool touch of an ornate bench. The relief it promised was too tempting. Ryan's knees gave way, and he collapsed onto the cushioned seat, a stark contrast to the hard control he'd exhibited all night. The thumping of his heart had become deafening, a cacophony that filled his ears and drowned out the distant melodies from the gala. He clutched at his chest, feeling the fabric of his custom-tailored suit crumple under his desperate grip. His breaths, sharp and ragged, cut through the silence of the hallway, each one a battle against the constricting force that threatened to suffocate him. "Help!" he tried to call out, but the word was a mere whisper, lost amidst the drumming in his chest. He fumbled for his phone, the sleek device slipping against his sweat-slick palm, before he managed to dial emergency services.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.